Welcome to our few moments together on the Parsha. This Shabbos we have the privilege of reading Parshas Vayakhel. It also is Parshas Shkolim. And here in our Young Israel Bethel of Borough Park, we're going to have the privilege of welcoming Moshe and Linda Fredge, the family that we adopted so many, many years ago, who have come from Eretz Israel to join with us for this beautiful, beautiful Shabbos. We're all familiar at the beginning of the Sedra of Ayakel that the Pasuk says the mitzvah of Shabbos, Sheshes Yomim Teyosa Melocha, on 6 days work can be done, but on the seventh day is Shabbos, you can't do any work. Rashi mentions right away that the juxtaposition, the placing of the law of Shabbos next to the law of the Mishkan, is that even though one may be involved in the work of the Mishkan, even though one may be involved in the work of building even the kingdom of Hashem on earth, the place where Hashem will be dwelling, it doesn't take precedence over the Shabbos. And the work of the building of the Mishkan must stop. Years and years and years ago, when people were in the early days of coming to the United States of America, let's say the beginning of the 20th century, when so many, many hundreds of thousands of Jews came, many threw away their Shabbos observance in order to so-called make a living. But those that kept the Shabbos and refused to compromise, because even when you're building the Mishkan, Shabbos takes precedence. Certainly when you're building your own personal wealth or even just making ends meet, it's hard to judge someone who has such a dilemma, and certainly we're not castigating any individuals, but the fact remains that the majority of the Torah community that remains alive today is only due to the forthrightness and mesiras nefesh, to the self-sacrifice of those who refused to work on Shabbos despite the fact that they were hard-pressed to make ends meet. Chassam Sofer, however, goes even a step further, and he makes an interesting observation. It's true that the building of the Mishkan does not take precedence over the keeping of Shabbos, but it should be noted that pikuach nefesh, the need to sanctify and save life, even if it's a doubtful pikuach nefesh, if someone has a child, God forbid, who is ill, and the parent doesn't know whether or not it's dangerously ill or not, the law is, if there's a safek pikuach nefesh, that safek pikuach nefesh pushes off Shabbos. Says the Chassam Sofer, look how valuable God recognizes the life of each and every human being, each and every Jew, that the life of a single Jew takes a higher position than the building of the Mishkan. The building of the Mishkan has to stop for Shabbos. But the life of every single Jew will take the Shabbos and put it aside in order to preserve that life. How precious, says the Chassam Sofer, are the lives of the Jewish people. How we should look at this pasuk, and we should say to ourselves, imagine that. The building of the Mishkan has to stop for Shabbos. But me, to save my life, to save any individual's life, any Jew's life, at any time, Shabbos disappears. How valuable in God's eyes are each and every one of us. What a powerful idea at the beginning of the month of Adar, which welcomes the successful fighting for the preservation of the Jewish people against Amalek. Let's take it in mind and have a wonderful, wonderful Shabbos.